the shade clean in.
My name's Barry the Blender Henderson. They call me the Blender because if you get in within reach of me, I'm going to turn you into a paste. But anyway, I'm an amateur mixed martial artist, and I'd like to just take you through my daily routine of how to become, you know, a deadly killing machine. So listen up.
I'm sure you've seen in movies such as Rocky 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that the best way to start a day is to have a glass of eggs just for protein and energy to keep your body going through an intense workout. So we're just going to do that right now. Let's
get that on there.
In the movies such as Rocky and stuff, they like eat theirs raw, but you know, I like to just cook mine, have a couple of scrambled eggs, because you know, it's got the same amount of protein in it, and there's no need to be eating a raw egg, that's fucking crazy. So this is my breakfast anyway, a couple of scrambled eggs, you know what I mean? Delicious. It's nice, right?
I do a lot of my own workouts in the garage. I've got everything I need in there. Start some warm-up exercises like sit-ups. Attack sit-ups, I call them. Attack an opponent from the bottom. Press-ups is another great exercise. I do the half press-up. You might know it as the girl's press-up, but it's very good for explosive power and tone. Another technique of mine is just to just give myself a wee smack in the face, because not a lot of people are mentally ready for smacking the face. But I'll be ready, you know, on the front line. And a very important aspect of my training is a thing I refer to as anal crunches, which gives you a very strong anus, which means when you're straining yourself, you're not going to blow something, you know, foreign out of your arsehole, i.e. hemorrhoids or a bit of lung.
I do have a good few heroes from various walks of life, but I've got three main heroes that I like to, you know, look up to, just to remind myself what the pinnacle of physical fitness actually looks like. If I just keep them on the wall there, if you want to take a look. Number one is Terry Hogan, and he's a professional wrestler. Back in the day, he's so good, he fought Andre the Giant, and the very next day Andre the Giant woke up dead. So, and then number two on the list, Chucky Norris, good friend of my dad's, and people make a lot of jokes about him now, you know, Chuck Norris doesn't do press-ups, he just pushes the earth down, you know, and that's all well and good, but he is a very dangerous killing machine. Knock your bollocks in, no sweat. But number one on my list, best fighter of all time from this very country, is Frank Bruno, just pictures over there, heavyweight champion of the world. Just says AM guns.
A lot of the time you don't have the luxury of a training partner, so you have to improvise. One of the many drills I do is, just hold a pad by myself and attack it as if it were an opponent, throwing punches, elbows and foot strikes. It's very effective for speed and reaction sort of training, you know. I also like to pretend with a heavy bag that I'm in a real life altercation and just practice my vicious single strikes, because that's all it takes, one strike to the face and you're dead, you know what I mean? Another aspect of my training is always to remember to stay calm and not jump in too violently and throw fists all over the place, because you leave yourself vulnerable to a deadly strike to the face and hence knockout.
Well, up to date I've only had the one fight, like, you know, but unluckily I was defeated. But you do learn a lot more about yourself in defeat than you do in victory. I did hear a quote once said, defeat turns gristle to muscle. Defeat turns bone to flint. Defeat is what makes man invincible. Not in my case, so my bone had to get a metal rod stuck up in it. But you know, I'm better off for it, like. One of the techniques you might have seen in moving pictures such as Karate Kid 1, 2 and 3 is they have a technique where they like to break a piece of wood, and it's one of my favorite techniques also. But like any form of martial arts, you need to know your opponent, and this is no different. You need to know everything about this wood. You need to know its weaknesses. You need to know everything about it when you're cracking wood. And I've got to love this technique myself. And you know, I have managed to break down the weaknesses of the wood, but I've also grown quite fond of it as well. You know, I do like the structure, the texture, the feel, and the smell of mature hard wood. Do you know what I mean? So one of the techniques I like to use is, like in Karate Kid 1, 2 and 3, he likes to break it over his skull, which I'm going to demonstrate for you just now. So don't blink, you'll miss it. I'm serious. Ready? 1, 2. Give us another go at that. Keep watching. 1, 2. I don't really see the problem with fighting. You know, fighting is the oldest sport in the world. People were fighting before they could even talk. Do you know what I mean? And I think a lot of the world's problems would be sorted out if you just had a good old scrap. Do you know what I mean? It really does sort out the men from the mice, or the wheat from the chuff, or whatever you want to put it. You know what I'm saying? What the fucking tell you? I probably would hit a woman if I absolutely had to, like. Absolutely.